What is going on, everybody? Today, I am here with my first ever Madden rebuild. So, we're going to be doing a Madden 17 rebuild today. We are doing the Los Angeles Rams, the new team or the new city in the NFL that got a team. So, we're going to be doing them. Let's use the active roster. So, if you guys want to see more rebuildings, let me know in the comments and let's see if this video can get over 700 likes for more rebuildings in Madden. So yeah, let me know in the comments what you guys think, and also let me know in the comments what team I should do next as well. So this is a whole new Madden thing this year, and we got to get into a rebuilding with the Rams. So we have the Los Angeles Rams, who have a 99 Aaron Donald, a 91 Robert Quinn, and an 86 Todd Gurley. We're obviously, we'll be the coach. I think that is fine. And then I'll edit all the league settings and we'll get into this. All right, guys, so this is the team. You saw the top three players before. Then we got William Hayes in 85, TJ McDonald. So you can see through the players now if you want to pause and see. But I think I'll make some trades, some signings in the first season. And let's just go to free agents here to see who's in it. This is probably going to be a longer process, and it's going to be the same three-year thing. Ooh, some of these free agents I might sign. Guys, we just completed a trade with the Bears. We traded Trey Mason for Kyle Long, so we get a nice right guard. And if you guys don't know how these goes, it's not really realistic or stuff like that. I'm just trying to win a championship in 3 years. So I think that's going to be all the trades I make for now. We're just going to see what this team can do after season one, and then we'll get into like free agency and the draft and all that stuff. So that'll be for me now, and I'll see you guys at the end of season number one. Okay, so this was our end of the season record. We went 9-6. And one, we actually had a tie. You can see it was probably with the Cardinals or maybe even the Seahawks. But we actually went 9-6. I'm actually now curious if we made the playoffs or not. It's a Chiefs-Packers Super Bowl. I'm almost positive. Did we make the playoffs? Oh my God, we did. We made it to the NFC Championship game, and we lost 28-14. How the hell did we make it that far? Definitely probably behind Todd Gurley. Wow, he didn't even do that well. Who did we beat in the wild card game or the division game? We beat the Saints, 21-7. Okay, I have no idea how we made it this far. Rushing. Todd Gurley even do that well. So Jared Goff actually played, I think, all 15 games. And he did 16 games. And he actually did pretty well in his rookie year. Rushing yards, Todd Gurley was a beast. 12 touchdowns for Benny Cunningham. That's weird. Receiving yards, yeah, we got to get that number one receiver that Jared Goff can trust. And blocking. Games played, okay. Honestly, the O-line was good besides Greg Robertson. I'm probably going to cut him in the offseason anyway. And who had the most sacks? Aaron Donald and, yep, Robert Quinn both had 10 each. And for interceptions, Akeem Ayers had 4. Okay, so TJ McConnell, we got to really re-sign most of these guys and see how much cap space do we have. Does it tell us? Will it tell me on the left? No. Will it tell me when I resign? Wow, it won't tell me my salary cap? That's annoying. All right, but I'll make all these re-signings. I'll tell you guys who I've re-signed and who I didn't. All right, guys, we have about $40 million in cap space, and we're heading here into free agency. Looking at the top, oh my God, this free agency quest is bad, but there's some guys in here that we can maybe go after. Okay, so you need, yeah, it's weird this year. It goes by, like, points. My depth chart, Dante Hightower would be good. He's out for 16 more weeks. That's 4 more months. Say we're in, like, nah, we're good. He'll be ready for the start of the regular season. So say I gave him this offer right here. That's what he wants. How many points is that? Like, it goes by weird. We are number 7. Oh, okay. So I definitely got to work on that, and I'll tell you guys who I'm offering contracts to. Okay, so I'm here with all my contracts done offering. We have $10 million left to spend, but I'm offering J.J. Wilcox, Jermon Bouchard a contract as well, Vernon Davis, Josh Gordon. That would be dope to bring him here to with Jared Goff, and you can see everybody else. So let's see if we can simulate pass week one or stage one or whatever, and then we can get most of these guys on the team, because that'd be cool. So let's simulate here, and come on, if we can land like Josh Gordon or like just if we can land like 90% of those guys, we would have a nice team. Okay, so JJ Wilcox, come, let's go. Who's this guy? I think he was center. I knew he was an O-lineman. Tremont Williams comes. There we go. We got all these guys on the team. That's pretty much everybody, I think. Let's see who hasn't signed with us. Did everybody that I offer contracts sign with us? Yeah, everybody did, I think. So that's dope. So, yeah, that's going to be it for me now. And I'll see you guys probably at the draft recap. And I'll tell you guys what rookies we have now. Alright guys, so I forgot we didn't have a first or a third round pick from the Jared Goff trade. So we, in the draft, got 271s, a 73 overall running back, 64, and a 64, yeah. So this is the rookies, and I'll see you guys at the start of season number 2. Alright guys, so the offense is looking okay. We got Jared Goff, Todd Gurley, Brian Quick, Tavon Austin, Josh Gordon's there. You see Vernon Davis, though. The offensive line's, it's all right. It's not really anything special, but that D-line, baby. You got William Hayes, Aaron Donald, Robert Quinn, and then you got Tremont Williams on the outside, as well as EJ Gaines. We have nice safeties, and our linebackers are iffy, but I think we can get back to the playoffs, and let's see if we can do so, and I'll see you guys at the end of season number two. All right, guys, I was going to cut in before the playoffs if we made it, but we were 3-13. We got progressively a lot worse. So this is the last offseason where I think we got to make a run in the playoffs. So let's see here. I got to go. I got to see what this team can do. I got to see where the weak spots are. I think Jared Goff might have gotten hurt. Yeah, he's down 2 overalls. He's got 38 confidence because we didn't win any games. Let's go check out the stats for everybody and see how everybody did. Yeah, he missed a couple games. Brian Hoyer was, oh my god, he was awful. Neither was Sean Mannion. We had to get a better backup. All right, Todd Gurley was still really good. Like, we're fine at running back. Receivers, we're good with Josh Gordon. Vernon Davis had actually a really good year, receiving-wise. Blocking, I didn't get rid of, I gotta cut him. I gotta trade him. I gotta trade Greg Robinson. Akeem Ayers was really good. Sacks-wise, 14.5 for Robert Quinn. Let's go. And interception-wise, EJ Gaines had 4. So let's just, you know, let's simulate here and just get right into the offseason for re-signings. All right, guys, Aaron Donald needs a new contract, so you know where all our money is going into. $110 million he is getting. He better accept this. Are you kidding me? Aaron Donald? Oh, okay. All right, Aaron Donald is testing in free agency. I guess he didn't want to come back. Oh, I could just franchise tag him, and that would probably honestly be cheaper. $13 million a year? I am fine with that. Okay, so we get him back. Alec Ogletree, I'm definitely going to try to bring back. I'm going to try to bring back most of these guys. I'll probably bring back Greg Robinson to maybe trade him. And yes, I'll see you guys at, I guess, who accepts and who doesn't. Okay, guys, so Alec Ogletree, all these people I'm either not bringing back or not, or they didn't want to accept their deal. So I'll see you guys in free agency, and hopefully it's a good free agency class this year. Actually, we could just go to it now. So let's advance to next week. Come on, please be good. I'm really looking for a better corner, a little bit better O-line, and a number one receiver. Can there, like, honestly, if Josh Gordon was our number two receiver, and then we had Tavon Austin in the slot, what? We only have $16 million to spend. Oh, man. And it's probably, it's an okay free, oh my god, it's not even a good free agency class. I did Jonathan Joseph and these two offensive linemen. I'm going to simulate here to the NFL draft, and I'm really hoping we have our first round pick this year, because then I kind of want to trade it, honestly, because say we get like an 80 overall, I could probably trade that pick for like a high 80 if we have it. Okay, we do have it. Wait, we have the number one pick this year? Are you kidding me? That value must be insane. All right, I'm going to try to find a blockbuster trade here. All right, guys, I think I'm on the verge of getting Julio Jones right about now. Come on, let's do this. Come on. Trade accepted, baby. Welcome to the team, Julio Jones. That is the number one receiver we needed. I think, honestly, I'm just going to trade all my picks right now. Like, I think that's the way to go right now. So let me see if I can move my second overall pick for a good offensive lineman. Oh my god, guys. Okay, I just got an 83 overall center and 86 overall right guard for my second round pick, my round three pick next year, and Roger Stafford the third. So, like, this team now is pretty filthy. Like, we have a good O-line behind or in front of Mr. Jared Goff now. So, we have an 83 and 86. I'm going to simulate through the draft now. I don't think I have any more picks that, like, are valuable. But, oh my god, Julio Jones there looks so nice. I'll see you guys at the start of Season 3 where I got to make some final moves for this team to possibly win a championship. Alright, guys, so I'm here at the start of Season 3. I think I'm going to be signing Elvis Dumervil here. He'll be a nice linebacker. He could either start, he doesn't even have to. Now, is there a good backup quarterback here? Brian Hoyer. All right, we could just $3 million. I don't want to give you that much. Brandon Whedon, 2.75. What does Ryan Mallett want? 1.64. I'd rather honestly go with that at this point. So, is there any other guys I could sign here? Alfred Morris. What about Matt Slauson? I don't think I can. Actually, I don't even think I have money to sign any of these guys. So, no, I'd have to clear up $870,000. It's all right. So I'm going to probably be making some big trades again with my first round picks for the next 2 years, because this is the last year. And I'll see you guys when I have the final team set up, or actually at my first trade. All right, guys, we just traded for Brandon Marshall, the middle linebacker, 90 overall for Lance Kendricks and 2 second round picks. So now we got a nice middle linebacker. I have to get a tight end. I don't know. I'm probably trying to get like a mid-tier one. So I'm going to see if I can move maybe like my fourth there. and my fifth there, and then like a player who's making a lot of money that I could just move. Benny Cunningham, okay, 2.4 million or whatever that said. And now let's go to tight end. Let's just see. Monta Williams, okay. Gary Barnage would be, and he's not even making that much, Gary Barnage. Hunter Henry, he's an 82 overall. Travis Kelce's making a lot of money. Dwayne Allen would be nice. Like, I'm looking for like an 80. Actually, you know, let's go up to the, who's the one? The Browns, Gary Barnage. Let's see if we can snag him for a fourth, a fifth rounder pick, and a Gary, Benny Cunningham, and we do get Gary Barnage, so let's go. We get him. Now let's check out the team. I'm not done yet. I still have to trade my first round pick, so those blockbusters are still gonna happen. We have Jones, Gordon, Tavon Austin, Cody Harkey. I think it's Cody Harkey. Jared Goff, Todd Gurley. The O-line is looking all right. It's looking all right. We have a good tight end in Mr. Gary Barnage. The defense, I probably should get maybe, I don't know. The defense is nice too, so this is gonna be interesting what final moves I make. Alright guys, we just got Riley Reiff, an 83 overall right tackle over from the Lions for a third and fourth round pick. So I still have two first round picks. I want to make those trades, try to get a stud player. So you'll see who I get in the final team. Alright guys, so yeah, by the looks of the division, we did not make the playoffs since the Cardinals won 14 games and the Seahawks won 11. It's of course because Jared Goff got hurt. Is that really what our season is going to happen on? Please tell me he was out for like one game and like that's why, but like, oh my god, he was out for most of the year. He'd even play a single snap. All year. Oh my god, really? We won 7 games with a backup quarterback? I would do another season, but we just don't have the salary cap nor anything else to do another season. We would just get demolished. But damn, okay. And our offensive line was so good besides our left tackle and right tackle. But, oh man, our defense was nice. Damn, okay, so that was it for me, guys. Let me know in the comments what team we should do next. And also let me know in the comments some like tips I should do. I think we would have made the playoffs if Jared Goff didn't get injured. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you thought of my first Madden 17 rebuild. I love you guys. Thank you all for the support. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.